Nike, to me, it's a name I'm long. They've been on as much of a tear in this last period. They're up 68% in the last 9 months as they've been in the last decade. So for all those people that were counting these guys out, North America Q4, you had an inflection point. China, for all the concerns around trade war, China's contributing 25% of revenue growth, about 18% of EBITDA growth. And I still think it's very well positioned in terms of women's growth, DTC. So I love the story. Not cheap.
Not long ago, I sold it. And for that reason, because it's not getting cheap. And, it was a couple dollars ago. But I got to tell you, with the Kaepernick thing, we talked about it that night on this air. We talked about the idea that it was a risk. And it was a risk that they wanted to take. And it's not the first risk Nike's taken in the past.
Did you sell before the Kaepernick ad, or did that make
you
think twice?
No, before the Kaepernick ad. And I wasn't, I don't think that was a reason to necessarily buy or sell, but I think there's still competition's going to be here with Adidas.
I'm in Foot Locker, disappointing earnings. I mean, I think the stock is really, really cheap. Obviously, they're not a brand, it's a distribution. So that weighs on the multiple by a lot. But to me, it seems excessive here, and it does correlate with Nike, even though in the very near term, it hasn't.
Yeah, I would just add, so they had this meeting today. There's obviously been a lot of talk about Nike. The stock's made new highs. It's up 20% since they reported last quarter. So these guys talking about growth, they're expected to grow earnings, mid-teens, sales, high single digits, that sort of thing. You're paying 30 times. It is getting a little expensive. I'll just add one point, though. Since they guided in late June, we're just talking about the dollar. 60% of their sales come from overseas. Tim just said 25% of their sales growth comes from China. So a weak dollar kind of gives them a little bit of a tailwind, at least as far as forward guidance. But I think, if you could get this thing back towards the low 80s and set up for a move back to 100 towards the end of the year, that's the way to do it.